Hi Scorpio, this is Wendy from Wendy's Tarot. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to be asking the cards what awaits for you in love for the week of May 1st to May 7th, 2023. I'm going to take a look at your energy, Scorpio, and then I'm going to see the energy of your person, whoever it is that you are connecting to and dealing with in love. All right, let's go ahead and get started. Just as a reminder, these are general readings. They might not resonate for everyone, but if it resonates for you, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'd really appreciate it. Also, I wanted to say if this reading resonates for you, I will put a link below the video in the description box that will take you to the extended reading if you are interested. Keep in mind, roles can be reversed sometimes in these readings, and also my readings are for Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus signs. All right, here we go. Let's take a look at some general love messages for you using this Oracle card deck. Spirit, angels, and guides, please show me what's going on between Scorpio and their person for this week. What's going on between Scorpio and their person for this week? The person Scorpio is connecting to and dealing with in love. What's going on between Scorpio and this person this week? Here we go. All right, first card we have here, Scorpio, is... it says rejected. Separation, split, or time apart. We need a break from each other. So you two are in separation right now, taking a break from each other. Someone feels rejected. All right, tell me more, Spirit. What's going on between Scorpio and their person for this week? It says home, new home, or moving in together. Let's make it official. Someone's moving or relocating or getting a new home. Someone's thinking about making this relationship official or wanting to make things official. Or that was the plan. Tell me more, what's going on between Scorpio and this person? One more card, please. It says maybe, unsure. Indecisive. Okay. So someone's not sure if they want to be in this relationship anymore. At the bottom, we do have mature man, young, grounded, practical, self-made, ambitious, own everything. Mature man. This is earth sign energy. Some of you are dealing with a Capricorn, Virgo, or Taurus. All right, we'll see what that's about. Let's look at your energy using the tarot cards. Let's see how we can make sense of this. Spirit, angels, and guys, show me the energy of Scorpio in regards to love for this week. What is Scorpio's energy in regards to love and in regards to their person? Whoever they're dealing with and connecting to in love for this week. What is Scorpio's energy, please? Okay. I see. Okay. Yeah, sorry. I was just hearing that this card is like the Four of Wands in tarot. The home card, which is also a card of relationship. Okay. Thank you, Spirit. What is Scorpio's energy in regards to love for this week? Page of Wands. The Ace of Pentacles, and we also have the Eight of Cups at the bottom, the Hierophant. Okay, we also have the Fool here. Oh, well, that's a contradiction. Oh. Yeah, this is like a contradiction here, the Fool and the Hierophant. This is like, the Fool is like an energy of being single and free, unattached, and the Hierophant is about being in a commitment. So someone's indecisive here in regards to whether they want to be single or in a commitment. Looks like the opportunity is here with the Ace of Pentacles, but it also looks like someone is walking away from this opportunity. This almost looks like someone who has been waiting for a message. Let's see. Hierophant, Page of Swords, Knight of Pentacles, and the Strength card. Hierophant, Page of Swords, Knight of Pentacles, Strength. Okay. Queen of Pentacles, Three of Pentacles, Three of Wands, Ten of Wands. There's definitely an energy here of, I feel like this is you, Scorpio. I feel like this is you basically deciding to just focus on your work, your money, your career. Pour all of your energy and time into those things and not this relationship. Because it's a burden with the Ten of Wands. I feel like this is you walking away. Yeah, it looks like you waited. Yeah. It almost looks like you were as patient as you could be. You were as patient as you could be. This Hierophant looks like you. Page of Swords. This feels like you were waiting for a message, Page of Swords. What message? Knight of Pentacles and the Strength card. Let me look at that. Let me clarify. All right, here we go. Spirit, tell me about this Page of Swords energy in Scorpio's energy. Why is the Page of Swords here? Action? Some sort of action or initiative? From this person is what you were waiting for. You see, yeah, strength is a card of patience. You were being very patient here. But now you feel like you wasted your time. Tell me about this Page of Swords in Scorpio's energy. The Seven of Cups. Confusion. This person left you confused. Tower. And the Four of Swords. High Priestess at the bottom. Page of Pentacles. Four of Wands. Eight of Swords. Oh boy. I feel like this is you saying this is not the one. You thought this was the one with the Seven of Cups. It's like you thought this was the one, but with the Tower and the Four of Swords, I feel like this is you saying no. This was just an illusion. This was just an illusion. This is not the one. I made a mistake. I misinterpreted. I made a mistake. I misinterpreted. It almost looks like you got your hopes up here for a second. For a second, you got your hopes up. All right, let me look at your person, see what's going on here. I want to keep these cards. I do. You over here, here. Rejected. You feel rejected? You're the one who feels rejected here? I feel like that's you. All right, let's see your person. Let me use a different deck. Spirit, angels, and guys, please show me the energy of the person, Scorpio is connecting to and dealing with in love for this week? What is the energy of this person? What is their energy towards Scorpio and the relationship or connection they have with Scorpio? I feel like you're saying, I guess I was wrong. I guess I was wrong. All right, in regards to your person and their energy, first card is the King of Wands. Oh, well, there you go. That's the problem here. You're the Queen of Pentacles, and this is the King of Wands. Tell me more about this person's energy. The Sun, a lot of ego, also Leo energy here. And the Eight of Wands. At the bottom, we do have Ace of Pentacles. Okay, that's weird. What's over here? The Ten of Cups is here. All right, what's going on here? This is confusing. Ace of Pentacles, Nine of Pentacles, Page of Cups, Five of Pentacles. Okay, well now I don't know who's rejected here, because this person seems to feel that way. Let me see. Let me clarify. What's this King of Wands energy spirit? Hold on, Scorpio. I'm figuring this out. Tell me about the King of Wands and Scorpio's person's energy towards Scorpio this week. Why the King of Wands? The Star. The Six of Wands. Tell me about the Eight of Wands. Nine of Swords, the Knight of Cups. Okay, this is someone making an offer to you. Tell me about the Sun. King of Swords and the Ten of Wands. Yeah, this is someone coming back towards you. Okay, it looks like there was an ending though between you two in the past. So this is someone who you already know, someone who you already experienced an ending with, and they're coming back with the Knight of Wands. They want to talk. They want to talk. They want to have a conversation. That's the message I was picking up on your energy. I feel like you were, it looks like you've been waiting for them. It's like you've been waiting for this person to message you or to talk to you. Okay. Okay, so I feel like this person made you wait too long. I feel like that's what's happening here. This person made you wait too long. And I feel like it's almost like you're in your ego a little bit, Scorpio. It almost feels like you're in your ego here. Like, when they didn't come to you when you wanted them to come to you. And now I feel like you're in this energy of, no, I'm not interested anymore. I waited for you. I waited for you that you never showed up, and I'm not interested anymore. I don't think that's true. I think you are interested. I just feel like you're wounded. Like you feel disrespected or offended by this person. Because it's like they're coming back towards you, you know, on their time. But it's like, what about your time? What about the time that you've been waiting here for them? Waiting to receive a message from them, waiting to receive an offer from them. It's like this person is not really taking that into account. They're just kind of in this energy of, yeah, well, I'm ready now. I'm ready now, so can we start this now You know, can we have a new beginning now? And I feel like you're in this energy of, no, I waited for you a long time. Like, who do you think you are? Because I feel like the way they're coming towards you, it's like they're coming towards you as if nothing happened, you know? As if they didn't waste your time. You don't feel like this person is really acknowledging. The fact that they hurt you and they wasted your time. You don't feel like they're acknowledging that. They're not taking that into account. It's like they just want to come back as if nothing ever happened. It's interesting because I feel like you want this Ace of Pentacles that they're offering. I feel like they're offering this Ace of Pentacles. Yeah. It's that they're offering it too late. And I do feel like with the Nine of Pentacles, I feel like you're in your pride, you know? You see the Strength card? This is pride. And it's ego, but ego is not always bad, so... But I do feel like you're in your ego and you're in your pride. Kind of like, this is like you saying, no, I don't want it anymore. Like, it's too late. That's what I wanted before, but I don't want it now. Again, I feel like you do want it. I feel like you're just upset here. Because you feel disrespected. And this person made you feel rejected, made you feel unwanted. And that's not okay. That's not okay. Yeah. Some of you saw yourself moving in with this person, because it says new home or moving in together. Some of you thought about moving in with this person and having something serious with this person. But I feel like you feel deceived, or you feel like it was an illusion. It was all an illusion. Read between the lines and catfish. Yeah. I'm just looking at these cards. It says read between the lines and catfish. Some of you feel like this person deceived you. They made you think they were someone who they really weren't. They made you think they were a mature man or a mature woman when in reality they weren't. All right, let's look a little bit more into this person. I want to look at the past, though. Let me just quickly look at the past. And I do want to look at this person, because I'm not getting a lot from them. What happened between Scorpio and this person at the past, Spirit? What happened between Scorpio and this person in the past? Five of Cups, Five of Swords. Oh, this person was playing games with you. And it looks like they had someone else also with the Lovers card. Okay. Okay, got it. Thank you, Spirit. Yeah. Yeah, this person was playing mind games with you, head games with you, and I do feel like they had someone else who they were involved with, who they were dealing with. And they chose this person over you. Yeah. They chose this person over you. and they let you go, this person might have ghosted you, or they just like disconnected from you, or they stopped talking to you. That's because they chose this person over you. But the thing is that with the Six of Swords, I feel like they're no longer together. This person is no longer together with this third party. This third party that they chose over you. They find themselves alone and without any type of, you know, relationship or connection with anybody. And that's why they're coming back towards you. Oh boy. Well, that's not nice. It's not nice because of the energy that they're in also. Like, they're just coming towards you with, like, this energy of, I don't know, like, arrogance, I suppose, or self-entitlement. I don't know what this energy is. Like, someone who doesn't have any shame, you know? Like, someone who doesn't feel shame or feel embarrassed. Or if they do, they hide it, or they ignore it. All right, let me look at their energy again. Yeah, exactly. Six of Wands and the Star. That's what I'm talking about. I feel like this person is like just not taking accountability of anything here. What's this King of Swords energy that they're coming towards Scorpio with, Spirit? Yeah, on top of that, King of Swords also. On top of everything, you know, King of Swords is someone who's like, someone who has rules, you know? Someone who has demands, expectations. Tell me about the King of Swords. Eight of Cups. Oh, what did I tell you? Emperor, there it is. Told you. Look at that, Eight of Cups and the Emperor. Like I said, this is someone who, like, on top of everything, they're coming towards you with this energy of having rules and having expectations, having requirements. So they're not coming towards you to commit. This is someone who wants to conserve their independence and their freedom. They're not trying to lose that. They're just trying to, like, reconnect with you. Have a second chance with you. Because they don't have anybody else. Because the person they did have, there's a separation. A separation occurred between them. And of course, they're looking at you like you're someone very valuable. Yeah, obviously. I mean, look at that. You're the Hierophant, the Strength card, the Queen of Pentacles. You know, you're someone who's loyal. You're someone who is reliable, dependable. They don't want to be with just anybody. This is someone who's showing up as the Emperor. Like, they're a player, but they're a sophisticated player. You know? They don't want to be with just anyone, even if it's just them trying to have a friends with benefits situation here, which could very well be the case. Even if it's them just trying to have a casual, you know, friends with benefits situation, like, they want to be with someone who's of quality. Even if it is casual, even if it is friends with benefits, like, they're not going to associate themselves with people that are not of quality. And the thing is that people of quality are not, you know, there's not a lot of them around. They're hard to find, you know? And that's why they're coming to you, because they're looking at you like you're someone of quality, of value, loyal, dependable, trustworthy. You know? So that's what's going on here, Scorpio. All right, I'm going to stop the reading here. Those are the energies that are occurring this week. I am going to continue in the extended reading. I'm going to take a deeper look at this person, and I'm going to see what exactly are their true and real feelings for you. What are their true and real intentions? And also, what actions will they take towards you by the end of the week? And I'll take a look at some advice for you as well. If you're interested, you can follow me there. Thank you for watching. I appreciate it. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys. Take care.